Hi, and welcome to the 30th day of Scope Month. Today is March 30th, so of course, we are giving away another MSLX 3104T. Now, I normally do this at the end, but I'm going to give you a moment now. While you're at it, and while you're here, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Click the link below. I'm just going to give you a second to click on that. All right, thank you for subscribing. Also, make sure you like our Facebook page. We have a new blog post that is live today. The link is below. It talks about analyzing your scopes and your system's bandwidth. Just because you have a 200 megahertz scope doesn't necessarily mean that you're able to look at a 190 megahertz signal. You have to consider the frequency response profile of your scope. Is it Gaussian? Is it brick wall? And you also have to consider how you're probing. So your probes and your scope combined may have a lower bandwidth. Check out the blog post. And since we're talking about bandwidth, the scope tip for the day is on why you would want to use the bandwidth filter in your scope. We have a built-in bandwidth filter. Maybe you don't want to use the full 1 gigahertz bandwidth if you have this scope. Now, why the heck would you ever want to bandwidth limit a scope? Well, noise is inherently random across the spectrum, and this is a 1 gigahertz scope. So in this case, I'm looking at a 1 megahertz sine wave, and I have some noise injected from an 80 megahertz arbitrary waveform generator. And we can look at the signal and see how a bandwidth filter would help us get a more accurate representation of what's happening on this signal. So first I'm going to adjust and get a stable trigger here. So I'm going to go to mode coupling, and I'm going to turn my hold off up a little bit until I get a stable trigger. So there we go. Now we have a stable trigger. It was triggering on both rising and falling edges of the noise, is why we saw that signal. And then if I want to turn on bandwidth limit and not see some of this noise, because it's a 1 gigahertz scope picking up at least 80 megahertz worth of noise, and then the random noise above that, I select the channel, and I just select bandwidth limit. Now you can see my signal looks a lot cleaner. So if you're looking at low-level signals, and especially if they're sinusoidal and you don't care about losing some bandwidth on your scope for that measurement, you can use the bandwidth feature and filter out a lot of that unwanted noise. So before we draw today's winner, I want to let you guys know that tomorrow and Friday we're going to be giving away a scope. We had someone who was unable to accept the prize, so we're going to draw on Friday as well, so a bonus scope draw. Let's see who wins today. We're going to draw one winner for an MSLX 3104T, and today's winner of an MSLX 3104T is Alex Coates. Congratulations, Alex. We will be in contact with you. So go check out the blog. We also have an internship available if you want to apply for that. Get your application in the next few days. We do cover relocation for that, and you can come work with the team here in Colorado Springs. As always, subscribe to our YouTube channel, like our Facebook page, hit the share button, tell your friends. There's only two more drawings left for Scope Month, and the Test to Impress contest is going live on April 1st. So make sure you get your entries in. I will see you tomorrow. Thank you for watching. So it might have been Alex Coates. Sorry if I mispronounced your name. I'm not going to say that. Should have brought my ukulele in for the, like, you should subscribe while you listen to this song.